home. I don't want to get murdered. I should go to bed. No, I should stay up and think about this more.
Quick, Jack! What are you doing?
What?
No one has heard from you in 3 days, and the tenants are calling me, and I hate that. What have you been doing, you lazy ass? You cute, lazy ass.
I've just been trying to go to bed.
For 3 days?
Yeah.
Well, everybody's stuff is like, it's missing, so go out there and figure it out.
But what if someone talks to me?
That's part of your job! Go, go, leave!
Please, no social interaction. Please, no social interaction.
Oh, hey, Crack Duck. How are you?
I don't know.
Someone stole my radio.
Yeah, I know, Jeff. That's why I'm outside. I gotta go, man.
But my radio. My hair!
No more social interactions.
What's up?
No more social interactions.
How are you?
I hate that question.
The Seven Truths Apartment Manager Crackduck.
Hi, Zquigix.
It's not Zquigix. It's
Zquigix.
Z-Q-I-Y-G-Y-X-Z.
Wait, Zquigix. Do you need something?
Phoebe Tim has stolen the sun.
I should have known it was Phoebe Tim. Wait, what? The sun?
I temporarily removed the sun from orbit and shrunk it down and was performing surgery on it when...
What?
It had a stomach ache. I had to operate.
I don't even know how that's possible. At all. The sun doesn't have a stomach, right? I mean...
You're missing the point, Apartment Manager Crackduck. Phoebe Tim has the sun in his apartment, and it won't stay shrunk forever.
Hey, man.
Hey, you doing your job?
Yeah.
Okay. Pretty cool. You know, we should hang out more. I got some DVDs down at my place if you ever
want
to kiss a little bit.
What? Yeah, you just asked if I wanted to watch DVDs and kiss a little bit.
No, I didn't.
Oh.
But, do you?
Do you? Excuse me. Hey, dude. We've got a big problem.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think Skilch has a crush on me, and I don't know how to feel about that, and I don't really know who I am right now. And also, the sun is inside Grungetown Towers, and it's growing exponentially larger by the second. What are you up to right now?
Nothing. What do you want me to do?
I don't know, just talk at him or something. I don't know how to talk for people.
Oh, hey, Phoebe Tim, this is Grub and Crack Duck. You can't steal stuff. It's rude.
No!
Hooray! Yay! Yay? Oh, no.
What are we gonna do?
I don't know. Kill it.
Kill the sun?
Yeah, murder the sun!
You're not making any sense!
Oh, sorry. It's loud in here.
That doesn't explain anything!
I'll take it from here.
Why didn't you take it earlier?
I could not knock on Tim's door to ask for the sun back. I do not have hands. And teleporting in would have been rude.
Okay.
Just as I thought, it was just the little god baby trying to create a new universe within our sun. All better. Thanks for helping me finish the surgery, Crackduck.
Dude, I have no idea what just happened. And this entire thing was like all your fault.
We could not have done it without you.
Okay, I'm going to bed.
Poor Tim. He was always so...
Thievy.
Yeah.
Wait! Look, we may not have to say goodbye just yet.
How cute!
Hooray! Thievy Tim is alive!
Hooray! Someone stole my flesh.
God damn it!
Kitty Hustler. Poppy Hustler. Get David Hicks.
Tuck, I don't think I really captured the whole I'm an idiot thing.
Ranger, don't be such a sad boy. You got like 450,000 hits.
Yeah, I know, but look at your video.
Holy schmiggles!
Yo, that cat messed up.
How did you make your eyes so huge?
I took Ritalin.
You did drugs?
So, the cuter we are, the more hits we get? I've got to go not get plastic surgery.
Yeah, me too.
I'm a cutie pie, and I love myself. I'm a cutie pie, and I love myself.
Hello, Tuck.
Since when did you have eyes? You got plastic surgery, too.
What? I got a Revlon. I thought we weren't even gonna get plastic surgery. Excuse me?
Hey! What is this?
My head is big and cute now.
Frack. Well, we'll just see who can carve themselves up to be cuter. So, Dr. Face Doctor, how about cutting off half my legs? That'd be cute.
Just cut them off the knees become ankles, nankles. You'll have nankles, it's adorable.
I've got frackin' ankles and I'm frackin'.
You were saying?
Frack.
Oh my god, stupid dog, you are soy cute, soy cute. Hashtag soy cute, Asian cute.
Who's the king of soy cute now?
Fucking frack, mother. I want curly princess hair.
I want a deer tail. Deers are cute.
Give me a bow tie made out of my own skin.
Put glitter in my sweat glands.
Give me bunny testicles.
Marshmallow teeth, please.
So this is my friend's chart, right? He told me specifically. He wants to look like a burn victim.
So he's a burn victim.
He's a burn victim sympathizer. It's a thing.
Okay, what about you?
How about you take my head, carve out my eyeballs, and make them something cute?
Oh, damn!
Oh, hey.
God, what have we done?
We're soy cute.
We've gone too soy far. They're saying we're ugly.
Well, I suppose this is all my fault. I just wanted to make you uglier than me.
You what?
It doesn't matter. I'll go get the suicide kit.
Okay. Wait, something's happening. What the hell is ugly as the new cute.blogspot.com?
Who gives a shit? They love us.
I'm a cutie pie and I love myself. I'm a cutie pie and...
Well, I finally got a date. Thank you, online dating, and the fat person Pictric.
I had fun. Thanks. So...
Here it comes.
This is my
apartment. Let's just be friends death blow. I already have friends. Well, a friend. Manjeet. He's my wingman.
Hello?
Ew! Get out of here!
I'm like sick to my stomach now.
Sorry, bro. They said you were very gross.
Manjeet lives with his seven brothers.
So, how was everybody's day?
Good.
Great.
Okay. I tried to hang myself again.
Manjeet is frozen in time from 1981 India. His outlook on life is a little dated.
A woman doctor? Come on, seriously. Where is your boss?
But he means well. He sends money home to his mom, and he feeds stray cats.
This is called tandoori chicken. That makes me homesick.
I had a good time.
I did too.
Yep, that's my voice. I'm Dee. I'm 29, unemployed, and I still live in my parents' basement. Most nights I spend cry dancing, eating cheese cubes, and drinking squirt.
Hey mom, can I have more cheese cubes, please?
And I love it.
Dee?
Now here comes the boom.
I think we should just be friends.
Slade, right in my he tits. Okay, think fast. I gotta stay in the game. Gotta get in that apartment. Smoothly?
Can I take a crap in your toilet, please?
Not smooth.
Look, I think you're great. You're funny.
All bullshit.
You're nice.
What she wants is a manly man. You know, one of those guys you see buying power tools at the hardware store.
I need a screwdriver for my eyeglasses.
Or like a hunter or something. Don't worry.
When I hunt, I use every part of the animal.
You know who else uses every part of the animal? The animal!
Think, Dee. Dig deep. Dig deep. Let's ask her a question. Women love questions.
You know the popcorn button on your microwave? How does it know?
Okay, I'm not that smart.
You got me thinking about microwaves. My coworker Cindy never cleans the one.
That's it. That's it. Nod and agree. Nod and agree. Even though you're mentally undressing her right now. Yeah. She looks hot.
And she's not even good at.
No! Don't undress yourself too. Ugh, gross.
Oh, I found a pretzel.
She always talks about.
See? See the emotions fly out of her? Now, just go over there and comfort her.
You're such a good listener.
And you're easy to listen to.
That's it. I am totally doing it. What am I doing? What am I doing?
You know what, Tammy? I feel a real connection between us. And I don't think we should spoil it this early.
What? Am I gonna see you again?
I'd like that.
I know I'm your conscience, but dude, I quit.
Dee, so did you bang that pussy hole?
Manjeet, come on.
All right, I'm back. Just to see this pic, though. And that's not a naked girl.
Yeah, that is very disappointing. I'm going to look out the window now.
Aww. I'm going to make this my screensaver.
Let's just try again tomorrow.
Seriously extreme fucking mother business. All right. Armageddon Corp's coming in today, and I really want to impress him, Rick. Let's get pumped up for this meeting.
I'm too pumped up already.
Let's calm down for this meeting. I'm feeling better. Let's get pumped up for this meeting.
Give me some coffee.
Give me some latte.
Give me more coffee.
Gappuccate.
I'm getting too pumped.
I'm gonna take your shit if you don't come down.
You don't have time to shit. This meeting's in 5 minutes, and this room
is tiny.
I can almost hear you from here.
It's pathetic. Armageddon Corp's gonna walk in here, and you know what they're gonna say to us? You guys' dicks are probably the size of girls' dicks. Call reception.
Shelly?
Hi,
how was your weekend? Oh, that's nice. Shelly?
The boardroom is too small. Call Office Depot or Staples or something.
Hey, guys, it's Office Depot, Staples or something Incorporated. Shelly says you guys want an expansion up in there?
We have 5 minutes.
Be right there. Let's do this! You want to supersize this room? You got it! You want expensive cars dangling outside the window to impress a big CEO type guy? You got it! First of all, I'm gonna go to the hospital. Bye!
Redress! Perfect! Now we're ready for Armageddon Corp.
Hey guys, it's me, Armageddon Corp. And this is my business posse, Jackson, Rickson, Dixon, and Pillsboy.
What the fuck, Pillsboy?
I thought you worked with us!
Fired!
Can't fire my guy.
Sorry, I'm just so pumped up. How are you doing?
Relaxed.
Shit!
Yeah, us too!
Fucking, I can't do this, I can't do this.
Now let's get pumped up for this meeting! Now impress me, boys.
Dollar sign, dollar sign, dollar sign, dollar sign, dollar sign, dollar sign,
dollar sign!
That was pretty good, guys.
Wait for the big finish, boss.
Dollar sign!
Guys, I'm gonna say this is a classic case of we have a deal.
We know it.
Now let's do something irresponsible and expensive.
Bald Eagle fights!
Business.
Local woman missing since Tuesday. Call the police if you have any information regarding her whereabouts. Her cats miss her.
My wife said she found you outside of a Walmart looking for work. Was that entirely true?
Huh. Uncanny.
Dante, why didn't you show me these eviction papers?
Oh, they just keep coming in the mail, trying to get us to join their swingers club.
Yeah, eviction isn't a poorly named sex club. These are legal papers, Dante. We're behind on our condo fees.
That's not possible. We're rich. Look, we have a celebrity maid, for crying out loud.
We're about to become homeless, and you're sitting there watching Rosie Perez stand-up specials.
Well, I wish my parents could bail us out of this mess, but, oh yeah, they're dead.
Thank you, Father. We will.
Sorry to interrupt, Mom and Dad, but you said something just now about a will?
That's enough, Dante. This isn't about you. I just lost both of my parents.
Yeah? Well, so did I. You're both dead to me.
You are unbelievable. My parents are dead to me, too.
Mm-hmm.
Hello?
Sauvignon, where are you? Your parents' funeral is today.
Ugh, I'm busy. Get over it.
There, problem solved. I put our spare room up for rent. Let the new roommate worry about those pesky condo fees.
Dante, we're on the 38th floor. Nobody can read that.
Well, illiterate people can't read it. We don't want illiterate roommates anyway.
Oh, God. Hi.
Hi.
Yeah, if you're here to buy drugs, our neighbors on the 35th floor are dealers. If you're here selling drugs, we're in a bit of a financial uncertainty right now.
Oh, no. I saw your ad in the window.
Really? How?
Well, I was on top of that building next door. I go up there to think sometimes.
What do you think about at the top of a building?
Jumping mostly.
Oh.
I'm new to this city. It is a lot bigger than the Sears Magazine 1988 Manhattan edition lets on.
You can't afford us, sweetheart. And besides, small-town folk couldn't adapt to our quirky lifestyle. Huh.
Good lord, they found a way to make money look ugly.
How did you get that much money?
Well, my townspeople and I were awarded a large settlement when it was discovered that our drinking water caused dehydration. But I want to start over in a big city. I want to live here with you guys.
Okay, we'll take your money, but you can't live here.
Oh. Okay.
Wait, wait! We'd love to have your money, and you, stay with us. Just until we get our financials in order.
All right, fine. You can stay in the guest's guest bedroom. But stay out of the guest bedroom. We don't like guests.
Oh my goodness, I can't believe this is happening. Just 20 minutes ago, I was in a lineup to jump off a New York skyscraper. And now I'm living in one! Guys, anything I should know before I start unpacking?
Yes. We're swingers and our life gets pretty messed up on a daily basis.
Oh.
Yeah. And our open relationship is an open wound and it festers into the lives of everyone we know.
Well, that's a colorful description, but sure.
Oh, you guys.
She thinks we're kidding.
Like a picnic in my nose!
There. I've made the perfect route.
Hey, doesn't your route go, like, right through a cage of hungry tigers?
Yes, but they won't be hungry after they eat a whole anteater eloper.
Hmm?
Ant,
what?
Eloper. You know, when two ants...
Yeah?
Want to be together, ants eloping.
Oh, really?
A black ant and a red ant, and they can't be together because society says no.
But they
want to be together. They love each other, and the family disapprove, but they have to go somewhere else. It's a Vegas
that's
wedding.
That's a thing,
and,
that's cool.
And elopers.
Yeah, racism is a plague that affects us all. Hey, haven't you killed, like, 5 animals in your escape plots?
Killed is a strong word. If they were electric eels, where would they plug in? Hmm? Now chop chop.
know, I really miss that horse-hung chimpanzee. Let's do 200 push-ups to Eye of the Tiger, man!
So you don't miss, monkey?
USA! USA! USA!
Chop up! We need to focus if we want to bust out of this place.
I don't know, man. I got it pretty good here. You know how many natural predators an anteater has?
No.
Neither do I! This place is paradise! Hey, watch this!
Oh, I can't believe you convinced me not to wear a bra.
Green, fresh, green.
Okay, bad example. But you'll never get me to leave this place.
In the real world, you can buy ants. They sell them in farms.
Hang on a mo. Did we ever solve the tiger
Whoops. And now I stroll to freedom. Alley-oop.
So many tigers!
Hey, not the yak sack. I don't think I'm ever gonna make it out of this hellhole. Well, at least I have my solitude.